Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the DiabetesCouncil.com, a researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today I'm going to answer the question, is Moringa good for diabetes? But before we get into that, make sure you download my free diabetes management book, which also includes a diabetes grocery shopping guide, foods to eat and avoid, by clicking the link below. When I got this question, I, like many of you, first asked myself, what is Moringa? So a little research, and I found that Moringa is a tree, which is actually the Moringa Oleifera, but many just call it Moringa, and practically every part of it are edible. Some people utilize the pods in cooking, others use the leaves. Oils can be pressed from the seeds, and the roots are also edible. And this tree's flowers are considered delicious, with a mushroom-like texture and flavor. It is native to North India, but is also found in Africa and Taiwan. Now, I found some people who call it the horseradish tree because of the flavor of the roots and other parts of the tree. Lately, it's being called the mystical miracle tree, with claims of curing many diseases. Now, in one serving of Moringa Oleifera leaves, you can find 22% of your daily value of vitamin C, 41% of potassium, 61% of magnesium, 71% of iron, 125% of your daily value of calcium, 272% of vitamin A, along with 92 nutrients, 46 antioxidants, 36 anti-inflammatories, 18 amino acids, including the 9 essential amino acids. Now that's a lot, and it sounds very good so far. A 2015 study at Addis Ababa University in Ethiopia concluded that extracts from Moringa leaves possess anti-hyperglycemic and anti-hyperlipidemic properties and alleviate pancreatic damage in diabetic rats. The beneficial effects of plant material in inhibition of diabetes-induced complications are still being investigated. Another 2015 study at the King Abdulaziz University in Saudi Arabia found that the antioxidants and flavonoids in Moringa also restored the diabetic rats in their study to the normal healthy state. However, the Ottawa Hospital research team has concluded that while these and other studies are promising, that based on the available experimental evidence, Moringa holds some therapeutic potential for chronic hyperglycemia and hyperlipidemia. However, before it is advocated in any formulation for treatment of these metabolic disorders in humans, state-of-the-art clinical studies must be conducted. So is Moringa good for diabetes? Well, it appears to be safe. You can purchase supplements, leaf powder, and other extracts online and in some health food stores. Will it cure your diabetes? No. It certainly may help to lower the blood sugar in some and help with lipid control, but it will not make your diabetes go away. I hope this answered your question, is Moringa good or bad for diabetes? Don't forget to get your diabetes management book by clicking the link in the description box below. And as always, let me know if you have any other diabetes-related questions. Thanks for watching. I'm Ty Mason.